Today we are going to study about primate. Right? This is an important topic in anthropology, which is mentioned in topic number 1.5 in first paper. So basically, primate, a study of primate, that is called primatology. So basically, for the understanding of primate, for the study of primate, we have to study primatology, right? So first, we try to understand about their important subject matter, that is, first, characteristics, second, primate taxonomy, and third, primate adaptation, and next, primate behavior, and next, we have to study living primates, and we also study tertiary fossils primate. So basically, it is an introduction class for the understanding of primate or primatology, right? This is very important topic, because in this topic we trying to understand about primate evolution, and in next topic, in topic number 1.6, we try to understand about human evolution. So in this topic we have to study primatology. So first, we try to understand what is primatology. What is this? What do we mean by primatology? Right? So primatology is an important sub-branch of biological anthropology, which deals with the study of, always remember, which deals with the study of evolution of primate. Evolution of primate. Right? First important thing, primatology focus to study about evolution of primate. And second, primatology also interested to study about evolution of primate behavior. So primatology has two important component. First important thing is a study of evolution of primate. So when we are talking about the evolution of primate, means we try to understand about evolution of prosimian, monkey, ape, and man. We know that man is known as a higher primate. So through primatology we try to understand about how human evolved from prosimian to monkey to ape and man. And secondly, we try to study about evolution of primate behavior, how there was development, there was evolution, there was evolution of a primate behavior. So because human behavior, right, that is regulated by social rule and regulation in our contemporary society. When we try to understand about human evolution on the basis of fossils remains, So basically, we only understand about human biological evolution. We have little evidence about the study of evolution of human behavior, basically behavior of our prehistoric ancestor, right? So basically, in primatology, primatologists try to understand about evolution of a behavior of non-human primate. Means, they try to study about the behavior of non-human primate like prosimian, monkey and ape. And on the basis of that study, they try to understand about the evolution of human behavior. Right? So basically, primatology focus to a study of this important aspect of primates. But how primatologists try to study about primate evolution and primate behavior, evolution of primate behavior. So for the evolution of primate, primatologists try to understand about evolution of primate through first fossils record. An important thing we utilize about the fossils record of primates, in which we try to understand about the fossils record of prosimian, monkey, ape and man. And second, now we also utilize genetical data or genetic method for the understanding of evolution of primate. So here primatologists try to understand human evolution by the application of fossils record, by the application of method, various method from human genetics. And secondly, when primatologists try to understand about evolution of primate behavior, they mainly focus to study about social behavior of non-human primate on the basis of observation in their natural environment or in laboratory. Here try to understand, primatologists observed about the behavior of prosimian, monkey and ape in their natural environment and also in laboratory. Here laboratory means they try to observe about behavior of prosimian, monkey and ape in zoo in restricted environmental condition. So this is primatology. But always remember that when we try to understand primatology, so an important question is that how primatology is different from paleoanthropology. So first important thing is that primatology is different from paleoanthropology because the scope of primatology is very wider, because paleoanthropologists mainly interested to study about human evolution. Their main focus is a study of human evolution, while primatologists not only interested to study about human evolution, but also interested to study about evolution of prosimian, evolution of monkey, ape and man. So their scope of primatology is wider than paleoanthropology. Secondly, paleoanthropologists did not interested to study about evolution of primate behavior or evolution of human behavior. They mainly focused to study about biological evolution of mankind. They are not interested to study about sociocultural behavior of mankind. Therefore, the scope of primatology is wider than paleoanthropology. So in primatology, we study that thing. Then we try to understand about their important topic which mentioned in our syllabus, that is characteristics, taxonomy, primate adaptation, primate behavior, living primate and tertiary fossils primates. These are important topic which mentioned in our syllabus. So first important thing is that when we try to understand about primate characteristic, this is very important topic which mentioned in our syllabus, right? So when we try to understand about primate characteristics, always remember that it is very simple. And one thing, if you try to understand about primate characteristics, because we are the member of primates, so if you give attention for the understanding of our own physical characteristics, you can understand some important points of primate characteristics. So first important thing here, I want to say that when we are talking about the characteristics of primate, means we are talking about the characteristics of prosimian, monkey, ape, and man. So first important characteristics about a primate is they have large and developed brain proportional to body size. This is very important characteristics about the members of primate. Here I am talking two important things related to their brain. Characteristics of their brain. This is very important. And this is two important things. Large and developed. You try to understand that two important thing when you try to understand about primate brain. So first important thing is that here we are talking that is their brain is large, proportional to body size. Always remember that here I am talking that proportional to body size, and that is developed also. So due to developed brain, primates have better intelligence, better cognition capacity than another mammals in animal kingdom. So this is important for the understanding of characteristics of brain. Second important thing is that when you try to understand about primate characteristics, so second important point is generalized body plan. It is very important when you try to understand about primate characteristics. Here, generalized body plan means they have no specialized organ. Primates have no any specialized organ. Like giraffe has neck and elephant has trunk. So primate has no any these types of specialized body organ. Primates have generalized body plans. So what is the importance of that feature? So due to generalized body plan, primates have great flexibility in their locomotion pattern. That is very important when you try to understand about primate. And then after that, when you understand about that topic, then we are talking about eyes. Some important feature in the eyes of primate. So it has some important feature. First is forward facing eyes. Forward facing eyes, right? Second is that is situated in bony socket. Third is they have color vision. And next is they have stereoscopic vision. This is very important when you try to understand about physical characteristics of primate. In their eyes, basically, when we are talking about the physical feature of the eyes of primate members, so first important thing is that they have forward facing eyes, and that forward facing eyes situated in bony socket, enclosed socket, that give them protection. And here I am talking about color vision. So always remember that a prosimian has no color vision. Why prosimian has no color vision? Because prosimian is nocturnal, and monkey, ape and man are diurnal. So there are no development of color vision in prosimian, but there are color vision in monkey, ape and man. And stereoscopic vision means three-dimensional vision. So these types of feature develop in primates member that due to adaptation with tree, adaptation with arboreal environment. So this is very important for the understanding of feature of primates. Next, when we try to understand about the physical feature of primate, so an important feature related to primate member, that is reduction in smelling capacity. Always remember that primates have less smelling capacity, means primate depend on their eyes, their brain for the adaptation of their environment than their smelling capacity, because when we are talking about they have large and developed brain, so due to development of brain, due to enlargement in brain, the olfactory area of primate become reduced, and therefore they have less smelling capacity, and therefore they are mainly depending on their eyes, their brain for the adjustment with their environment. So this is also very important feature of primate members. And then we are talking about they have generalized teeth. So generalized teeth means they have no specialized teeth for a special purpose. They have four types of teeth, that is incisor, canine, premolar and molar. When we are talking about the teeth, so in the course of primate evolution we found that there are reduction in the area of teeth, second, reduction in the size of teeth, and reduction in the number of teeth. This is very important thing related to primate when we try to understand about teeth, evolution of teeth of primate, and about the nature of teeth of primate. This is very important thing. And then we have to talk about there are 5 digits in their hand and feet. Second important thing is that when we try to understand. It has nail rather than claw. So when we are talking about the feature of finger, we found that they have nail. Nail, not only we have nail, but a nail present in prosimian, monkey, ape and man, all. Second important thing is that in their hand, they have touch pad, right? And there are development of rings in our finger. And another important thing is that opposability in hand, right? Thumb, there are great opposability in thumb, in all, and therefore grasping capacity found in the hands of primate member. One thing you also remember that monkey, ape and prosimian, they have opposable toe also. So due to opposability in toe in prosimian, monkey and ape, they have grasping capacity in their feet also. But that opposability in toe was reduced in human ancestor due to adaptation of bipedalism on land. So it is also very important feature when you try to understand about primate characteristics. Then we try to understand an important feature related to clavicle bone, right? Clavicle bone, this is. And it has great flexibility, and therefore primates member capable to move their hands up and down, and this gave us very great flexibility, not only for the adaptation on tree, but also for the catching something by hand. It is very important thing. Next, when you try to understand about primate feature, so generally female, because here I am going to discuss about some important feature related to reproductive organ. So generally primate female bears one child in one time. They are generally reproduce one child in one time because natural selection was in the favor of that. And second important thing is that human, basically male, their penis is pendulous. This is very important reproductive feature of primate member. And after that, when you try to understand about there some feature related to reproductive also. So primate children, dependency of primate children, they are long time depend on their parents, right? Because their brain is developed, so at the time of reproduction their brain is underdeveloped. So due to growth of brain, primates children long time depend on their parent. And another important thing is that they have social behavior, right? That we will discuss when we are going to a study about primate behavior. So primates have social behavior. They have social behavior like relationship between mother and their children, and a relationship between male and female, and child caring practice. These all things present in primate, and through that you can understand about primate characteristics, and therefore on the basis of that you can understand about primate characteristics. Thank you.